All right, what's up, everybody? We're here with Mike Bickings today. Art of War 36, stacked card, as always. Mike, tell me what's going on, man.
We got some good shit tonight. I had to bring this in because I'm so excited about all the fights. Butterworth and Hewitt are debuting against each other. Coble and Samaru, I don't know much about those guys. I just know they're from really good gyms. Jay Watson, for a moment, held our Art of War knockout of the fastest knockout in Art of War history.
Ooh.
Then they ruled it a no contest because the guy's knee was on the ground. Jay has super fast hands. Mike Neal's a newcomer. We'll see what he has, but that should be a good fight.
O'Toole coming back.
O'Toole is my guy, man. I'm Irish, so every time I hear Dropkick Murphys, I get excited. Yeah. I get chills. He's fighting Alexander Bendinelli, both guys Division I wrestlers. When two D1 wrestlers fight, that's normally a great boxing match if neither can take the other down, so we'll see. Nicolas Kikvidze,
always
2-0 right now.
Nicolas, it's exciting to watch, man. I like that guy, man. He brings it.
If he gets one more win, that's 3-0. It's time for a title.
I think so.
Versus Zachary Kitchell, another newcomer. Cade Berardelli has been on a mean streak.
He's been busy, man. Busy, man. Every card I see him fighting, man.
Cade is about this. Cade's trying to go all the way to the UFC, and he definitely has the potential. Liam Gray, we got to see. I got a couple new guys that we haven't used yet. Joey Milano is fighting for his first Art of War title.
Awesome.
Advanced rules, which is terrifying, because he is a apex wrestler, and to have that dude on top of you is scary shit.
It's terrifying, bro. And what do we know about his opponent? I really don't know who he is.
Ulysses Moore.
Ulysses Moore is 4-1 out of Orlando.
Oh, so he's out of Florida. He's a Florida guy.
Yeah, he's a Florida guy. 4-1. He trains at a real good gym. I believe it's ATT, I want to say.
American Top Team?
Yeah.
That's a tough school, man.
So he's getting some rounds in with good guys. So this isn't a setup. This isn't no Milano.
ATT guys are savvy, man. That's where, like, Dustin Poirier and all those guys are at.
Yeah.
George Masvidal, all those guys.
So he's getting rounds in with top-notch dudes.
Probably.
So.
Yep.
It's going to be a hell of a fight. James Padmore and Kale.
Excited for that one.
My boy Kale.
Yeah. Kale's has won his last fight with leg kicks.
I know. I never seen a TKO
by leg kicks. I was like, what's going on here?
Never seen that before. This right here next has the potential to be the fight of the year. And Dylan Abraham Charles. Neither have a backup gear. They go straight at each other. They're going to throw bombs.
Yo, Anthony Dill is a savvy dude, man. He does a lot of the combination fighting with, you know, the MMA, the boxing.
Pro boxer.
Yeah.
Great hands. And Abraham Charles, we've seen him.
He's a dog. He's a beast. He's a good grappler, and he throws bombs, man.
Yeah. I saw Ant Dill at the Matt Return Open. They have a big wrestling event that happened in Allentown. Dude's well-rounded, man. I'm excited to see
anything
him
work. Combat, Ant Dill, anything physical. I think he does roller derby on the weekend. Ant Dill's a maniac.
It's pretty wild.
And then, next, of course, Johnny Garb. And
Johnny Garb.
Newcomer. That guy's from out of state?
Yeah, Garb was supposed to fight Greg Sizemore.
That was another guy that I seen. So this fight he's a replacement?
Yeah, so Sizemore was sparring. Johnny Garb was supposed to fight Greg Sizemore. Greg broke his arm.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
So tragic accident. Bryce training.
So to find a replacement for an undefeated pro is not easy.
Especially Johnny, man.
Yeah.
They know Johnny. Johnny's got a lot of fights on YouTube.
You got to have thick skin because the Garbarino crowd will boo you out of the building for even taking the fight.
Scary crowd, man.
But Mike Ahearn is the truth. He's 3-2. He's exactly what Garb needs at this point in his career for a nice test. That's going to be fantastic. So we'll see how that works. And
The main event. I'm pumped about that one, man. That striker versus a gritty grappler, man.
Super high-level grappler.
Super, man.
That's going to be a total
resilient, tough mofo.
We're going to see some advanced stuff, I think.
Lopez, people slept on him, and then he came out here and he gave Brian Cafaro a hell of a fight.
Which is one of the better 145ers in the Northeast, man.
So Lopez is legit, but Stefanelli is the 140 champ. When he's on his game, he takes anybody down and punches holes in them. So that's going to be a hell of a fight. Whoever's the better version of themselves is going to win that.
I agree. I totally agree, man.
Yep, that's amazing stuff. Well, thanks a lot for giving us the rundown, Mike.
Shout out Danny real quick. This is my brother and my security guy. He's the one that'll throw you out if you play games at Art of War. So going to be a hell of a show tonight.
Awesome, man. All right, let's hit the corners.
is foul, 30-27, in favor of your winner, by unanimous decision,
that shirt.
Thank you, bro.